quite a bit of generosity in recent months and days of people stepping up to help in the aftermath of natural disasters and other tragedies.
Unfortunately, scammers are also coming out to take advantage of people trying to help. New this morning, Palosuro shows you what you need to know when you want to give back.
In the midst of natural disasters from Hurricane Harvey to Maria and the mass shooting in Las Vegas, people turn to social media to donate and lend a helping hand. But that's also when scammers are out and about.
Scammers look for the opportunities where people are in a dire situation or a negative news story has happened, and they figure out ways that they can make money off of it.
The BBB is making sure your money ends up in the right hands. They've got more than 11,000 charity reviews covering local and national nonprofit organizations.
We actually do go through and make sure that charities are fully disclosing where the money goes, that they do have an updated tax form.
Now, there's some things you should look out for.
Look at the webpage itself. Are there a lot of spelling errors or grammatical errors, or is the terminology just a little bit different?
You want to make sure your credit card information is going to a secure website. That means it's using HTTPS or the padlock symbol when hitting donate.
And even when it comes to donating physical items, double check they are certified, because the BBB says only a few select charities will actually be sending items.
They get an influx of items. A lot of times they'll end up in a warehouse and never make it down, because right now the need may be cash so they can buy the items to help the victims.
And to triple check, you can even call and ask what it is they need.
And speaking of charities that are sending items here locally, Cincinnati for Puerto Rico has been working hard to collect items to send back to the island. Just 3 days ago, they were able to load a total of 5 trucks, more than 10 pickup trucks, and 20 cars with items they're going to send. They have a total of 92 pallets ready to send to Puerto Rico. I'll have information on their organization and how you can help at WCPO.com, of course.
And we've been talking about the fact that your family was there. And so how is everybody doing?
They are a lot better, thank you for asking. My grandparents still have no water, no power, like most of the island. Mm-hmm. But my aunt was able to check in on them yesterday.
Good.
So at least they're able to drive
stay.
To them.
They're going
to
stay and
apparently,
wait it out.
Apparently, we got them tickets to come back, but my grandparents kind of want to stay. You know,
I think
older.
That goes for a lot of people.
Yeah,
yeah, Florida, Houston, absolutely. And now Puerto Rico as well. Yeah. Well, thank you. We're glad everybody's doing all right. Thanks for coming in.
6:30.